what's up everybody? I hope you're all doing great. First of all, welcome to all the new faces, glad to have you here. Oh, and by the way, the intro sequence was actually lit with those little M9 Emerin by Aperture. If you're a little involved into the tech space, you know Techtober, that's usually the time when your gear is launched, and as it's currently February, there's literally no gear talk on YouTube. So that's why we're talking about what's my camera bag, or what's my current camera setup, and definitely not because I haven't found the time for doing so before. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so let's start with the camera bag. I'm using the Loewe Pro Protectic BP450 AW Mark II. And people are getting angry about phone names these days. So what I love about the backpack is that you can just customize the complete inside to your liking and what you need. So it could be an everyday backpack or a travel bag. Then I love those zippers. Those are actually the best zippers I've seen on a bag ever. They're so easy to operate, even... Operate. Let's just say operate. They're so easy to operate even when it's cold outside and you have gloves on or frozen hands, if that's your thing. But this thing is just so easy to open and close. While we're talking about opening and closing,
oh, that transition.
You can actually access the inside from four sides. So you've got two side access options. Then you've got a top access where you can just put in a jacket or something or a gimbal. And then the back access where you can basically just take out whatever you need. What I also like is the waist strap, which is really comfortable. Therefore, for some reason, the shoulder straps are really uncomfortable for long days. And I'm not a big guy, by any means, but they're just rubbing against your neck, basically, the whole day, which is not the best thing. Oh, and another thing I hate about this bag is the laptop sleeve. There's just no way I can put my laptop in there without worrying it will just break. So it's the perfect everyday backpack for me and for something like weddings. But if you're mainly doing hikes, there are definitely better options out there. Alright, enough back talk, let's start with the gear. My main camera body is the Sony a7 III, which I'm filming on right now. As a backup, I've still got the a6500, which is not a bad camera by any means, but I need those two SD card slots for client projects. Alright, let's talk lenses. So I'm using the 17-28 2.8 by Tamron, which I'm filming on right now. That's basically my YouTube lens. I'm using it for vlogging, I use it for landscape photography, astrophotography and all that good stuff, architecture. Then next up I've got the 28-75 by Tamron, also 2.8, which is just a great versatile lens for video and photo work. Then my main photography lens is a prime lens, the 35-14 by Sigma. I just love the look of a 35, that's why I've got this one. It's just a fixed focal length, therefore you get the fast aperture of 1.4. I hope they put out a DGDN version, so one especially made for mirrorless cameras, which just brings down the size and weight. Alright, let's talk filters next. I've been using the Haida 226 stop VND for a pretty long time, basically since I started photography and video. And the Haida had two problems. First, it had a weird greenish yellowish tint. And second, it got a pretty heavy vignetting at around 5-6 stops. So that's why I recently switched or upgraded to the Freewell ones. They're basically the same price, but just way better quality. So I bought the 2-5 stop VND and I've got zero problems with it so far. No tint, no vignetting or something else, which is really nice. And I really wanted to try out mist filters. That's why I bought the 1/8 stop mist filter, glow mist filter from Freewell, which is on the lens right now. And bought a matching 2-5 stop X mist filter with also 1/8 of diffusion strength, so I can easily match indoor and outdoor shots. And then I've also got those little mini ND filters with inbuilt polarization actually for the Mini 2. If you have no idea what I'm talking about right now, just drop a comment down below and I'll make a video about filters. Alright, let's talk drones next. So for Christmas I bought myself the Mini 2 to try out drones and I discovered I really loved them, so I'm just thinking about getting into FPV drones later this year. But for now the Mini 2 will do. But yeah, the Mini 2 is basically always my backpack now, together with the controller obviously, and also the two-way charger for three batteries and the controller to just have more juice to fly even more. The next thing which doesn't leave my backpack anymore is the DJI RSC2, and I'm just really happy with this gimbal. The arms are a little more stiff than the RSC2, especially the roll axis. You can hear it, kind of, how the metal is grinding on itself. And I'm absolutely ready to live with this drawback as this thing is just so small and light. So it can come with me everywhere. For a tripod, I've always got the Joby GorillaPod 5K with me, which I'm filming on right now. It's just the most versatile tripod that you can get anywhere. Then for audio, I've got the Rode VideoMic Pro, which I'm using right now. If you're in the market for a microphone right now, I definitely recommend the Pro Plus version, as the Plus version automatically turns on when you turn on the camera. And the Plus version records on two tracks with different levels. So if you peak on one, then you still have the other track as a backup, which is really convenient. If you want to film outside, you should definitely pick up the Deadcat, which just diffuses the wind, so the microphone doesn't pick up that much wind noise. Always have with me a rocket blower, a little microfiber cloth and the lens pen, which is just handy to clean up your camera stuff. And I always have a time-lapse remote with me, as the Sony cameras do not have an inbuilt time-lapse mode. Theoretically, I also have the GoPro, but as my life is boring, this thing is usually in the closet. Alright, that's it for today. Smash the like button to please the algorithm, and drop me a comment down below what you want to see next. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm using the Loewy Pro Protectic BPAW. Get this thing out of my face.